meaning to the word greed. Like, all right, let's do this. So welcome, everybody. Good to see everybody. I know you guys are joining from around the world. We are going to have the cheat meal of all cheat meals today. It is going to be amazing. I have been waiting for this day, not only to support and feed my own personal greed, but also these weeks have just, they've been like the longest, craziest weeks for us. And if I feel it, I know that so many of you guys are feeling it too, around the world. So hello, everybody. Good to see everybody joining. All right, here we go. So before we get to the, let me know where you guys are at, by the way, and where you're from. Good to see you guys around. So before we get to the 4-inch thick cut French toast, as always, what's up, Brazil? Good to see you in the house. I hope you guys are doing great. Rosario, mwah, good to see you. I should do a live video with Kevin Hart. You know, look, I do a lot of things with my son, Kevin Hart, but now's the time, you know, that I'm letting him right now, I keep him in his cage. So it's just gonna be me and all of you. All right, so here we go. So as always, before we kick this party off, in order to kick it off, right? We're gonna make a drink. Last week, I made for you guys the Terramana Tequila People's Margarita. It's been a big hit. And thank you guys, by the way, for just all your posts. Your posts have been so creative. They've been so fun and they've been so genuine, by the way. And it's just been so awesome. I'm so happy that you guys love the Terramana and that you guys are really enjoying it, especially during this time. So happy in my little way that I'm able to bring you guys a little bit of joy and comfort during this time. One of the big questions, by the way, that I've been getting about the Terramana all week long, actually it's the biggest question is, how do I know if my local liquor store sells Terramana? Well, honestly, simple. You just got to call them up and see if they sell it. We have been slow rolling across the country. And you know, in the slow roll, there's been tens and tens upon thousands and thousands and thousands of cases being delivered, but it's slow rolling. So call your local liquor company. They do curbside service. A lot of them do. I'm so happy that, you know, a lot of the small businesses, those small liquor businesses, those mom and pop businesses, liquor businesses, large and small, are staying open, and keeping those families in business. Okay. So here we go. We're going to make a drink. Then we're going to get to the, main event. Last week we made the People's Margarita. This week we are going to make the, Terramana Tequila, Sunrise. Last night I called it the Terramana Tequila Sunset, and you know, which goes to show, which goes to show, I don't know what day it is or whether the sun is coming or the sun is going. I'm sure like a lot of you guys. All right, let's first start with the Terramana Tequila Blanco. A couple of ounces. That's way more than a couple of ounces. I failed math, so it's okay. I always round up. All right, here we go. All right, we add a little bit of orange juice here. Again, I just go by feel, but you know, I let the bartenders know that it should be about 2 ounces and just splash of this, a splash of that. We go with a little bit of the Lamana secret sauce, which is a little bit of pineapple. Just a splash. Then what we'll do here, we'll take these orange wedges, a little squeeze. It is way more Terramana than OJ. Thank you for noticing that. All right, and I like to throw the orange peels in there, and just the orange wedges in there, because you get the the rind, you get some of the pulp, you get that quality. You gotta get it. Good. Do a little thing like this. Because I think I'm cool. That makes me cool. Till I drop this shit all over the house. Oh, you guys are having a blast. 2 ounces, and I pour in 2 cups. Okay, you can never have too much Terramana. All right. making me good again. And ladies and gentlemen, I raise this glass to you guys around the world, this Terramana tequila sunrise. This toast goes to our front line, our first responders, our healthcare workers all around the world, certainly here in the United States, and all the hard work, the endless commitment that you guys are putting in. And I thank you, because we all at this point know somebody who knows somebody who knows somebody who is going through it with this virus. And many of us are dealing with it on a close level too as well. So I toast to you guys. Cheers. Enjoy. Hold your glasses up of your Terramana. That's good. You guys keep sending me your pictures, by the way, and your videos. I appreciate it. That sounds a little weird and creepy. You know what I'm saying. That's good. As you guys are drinking your Terramana, show me all the cheat meals that you guys are eating. So from Dark Side of the Ring, you guys asked me, how would I think I would have done in Brawl for All. So if you guys have been watching, if you are a fan of professional wrestling, which I am, there's a show on Vice, which I really enjoy. It's called The Dark Side of the Ring. And of course, based on the title, it deals with a lot of things that are, I know you guys are like, get to the cheat meal. I know we're going to get to the cheat meal. It's right here. We're getting to it. But I have been, you know, this, the Dark Side of the Ring, it's an inside look at some of the darker, more tragic stories that have taken place in professional wrestling. And so every single episode, I am so just personally connected to all of these, because I grew up in the professional wrestling world. So my grandfather, my dad, my cousins, I mean, everybody. So I know everybody who they are profiling, and, it's really quite the show. And quite the series. How would I have done? Are you kidding me? I would have introduced him to the Hammer Brothers, Sledge and Jack, baby. Then I would have gotten knocked out, probably. But I go down swinging. All right, here we go. Thank you guys for the love. Good to see you. Good to see you, France. Good to see you guys. Good to see you, Middle East, too, as well. I just don't want to put the drink down. They say that success happens when you see the world through the bottom of a glass. All right, there we go. On to the main event. Here we go. All right. So this week's main event, this cheat meal, this is going to be, what's up, Italy? Good to see you. I'm glad you guys are in the house. So this cheat meal, if you guys could see it, this is 4-inch thick French toast, and it is a personal recipe of mine. It's a specialty that I love. It is my go-to every single week. Now, this isn't only what I have. I have this, and I'm sharing this with you guys, but I also have some, usually some cookies, some chocolate chip cookies. I also have the chocolate chip cookies, but here's the thing with the chocolate chips. I don't know how you guys feel, but I gotta have milk chocolate. Milk chocolate. I'm not a big semi-sweet fan because it's a little, there's a little bitterness quality to it. So I gotta have the milk chocolate. I also do big peanut butter, chocolate chip cookies too as well. And I do a ton of pasta throughout the day, but it's today. What's up, Canada? Good to see you. Usually Sunday is my cheat day. And the only reason why I know it's Sunday, because I've lost complete track of days, I'm sure you guys have, is because it's cheat day. All right, so here we go. The main event, brioche French toast. If you guys can get your hands on some brioche bread, I cut it 4 inches thick, because I am, I'm greedy. And I love a big thick ass French toast. So basically when you put these together, this is the loaf, and then I cut off the ends of it. And then I cut off the ends of it here. And then the ends, what I usually do is I usually make a grilled cheese sandwich. Cause the greed and the cheat meals, it just keeps going throughout the day. What advice would you give my team, two people making their WrestleMania debut and Raw? Okay, so Zelina Vega, Thea Trinidad, good to see you. What advice would I give you guys? Stay healthy. That's the advice I would give you right now. And also, she's this big match for WrestleMania. And I've known her for years very, very proud of all her accomplishments. And, you know, look, I got to tell you guys this. Before we get into this, you're like, Rock, no, eat the cheat meal. I know, I'm going to. Stay with me. I got it. But it is WrestleMania weekend. WrestleMania took place last night. So big this card was that it takes two nights. And so WrestleMania started last night. It goes on tonight, too. We have some really big matches tonight. And I will answer one question about WrestleMania, which everybody has been asking me. What is my favorite WrestleMania moment? Yes, this is French toast. Yes, it's a loaf of French toast. I would say what you guys got to do, honestly, is you guys, what my answer to you, Thea, is, and to all the hardworking men and women, WWE superstars, it's such a unique thing that you guys are trying to hold WrestleMania with no crowd. So it requires a certain skill set. So I would just advise you to go out, act as if a crowd is there, give it all you got, and stay healthy as best you can, and eventually we're all going to get through this thing, and you guys are going to be working in front of your 80 million people. Those are in my fantasies. You guys are going to be back working in a full crowd very, very soon. So keep up the great work, Mama. I'm proud of you and all of the women in that locker room and all the dudes too. I know you guys are working your asses off, especially during this crazy time. So a nod of respect to you guys. Okay, here we go. This is it. But first, I got you guys. Here we go. my favorite WrestleMania moment was would have to be the very first WrestleMania that I main evented with a guy by the name, some of you may know him, Stone Cold Steve Austin, one of my good buddies. And I lost that match, but I came in the youngest WWE heavyweight champion ever. And he beat me right in the middle of the ring, 1-2-3. It was my favorite WrestleMania moment. You're probably like, why is that your favorite Mania moment? Because you lost. It was my favorite moment because he was the number one guy in the company, and he trusted me to main event with him. And the WWE is a company who was just getting ready, who was just skyrocketing and just getting ready to become a publicly traded company. So the company itself was on fire. And the reason why it's so special to me is because they trusted me in that position. And I went out and I grabbed that brass ring I didn't let it go. And even though I lost, beat clean in the middle of the ring, 1-2-3, in the loss is where I actually won big. So that's my favorite WrestleMania moment. Cheers to everything at this point. Okay, here we go. So I've already warmed this up, by the way, so this is not cold. I warmed it up about 15 minutes ago. It's still mushy. It's still good. Look at that. This is very weird, because I'm making it weird. All right, first things first. So here's the thing, here's the ingredients. We have peanut butter. This is the first thing that goes on. Knife. This is one of my favorite songs right here by Cody Jenks. You guys are country music fans. Cast no stones. So, here we go. Traditional country. So, I'm smothering this French toast in peanut butter, as I do. Now, keep in mind, usually when I do this, when I'm doing these French toasts, when I'm doing my French toast cheat meals, it's usually, honestly, about 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock at night. And it's just me. I don't turn any of the TVs on. I sit in front of my computer, my iPad, and I turn on either Netflix or Apple or HBO or ESPN. I just watch documentaries. When everybody's asleep. But now I'm breaking this out with you guys. Just want you to see what I'm pulling out here. Again, sounded weird. Like I was back in college. Okay, look. Look at that. Here we go. Here we go. My business. There we go. There's a lot of comments after a post I posted last night when I told you guys about the, you know, the other careers that I wanted in my life before I do what I do now, which was I wanted to become the heavyweight boxing champion of the world at one time. And I actually had this dream about being a country music singer. True story. When I was in Nashville, one fateful night on Music Row on Broad Street, when I was 15 years old, changed my mind. All right, next up, jelly. Any kind of jelly. I'm going with blueberry right now, but I like blueberry, I like blackberry, I like strawberry. I like all kinds of all kinds of jellies. Not a fan of marmalade. I gotta say, if there's any marmalade fans out there, sorry to disappoint you, but not a fan of marmalade. All right, here we go. I hurt nobody. Somebody found their way. Terramana's kicking in, guys. All right. Here we go. There you go. Take a good look. That in total is 8 inches. Again, like I'm back in college. It all happened in college. All right. 4-inch thick French toast, peanut butter, jelly. Here we go. Now it comes. How many calories do I think that meal is in totality? It is a lot of calories, and throughout the day, I eat a shitload of pastas and breads and carbs, because I also usually train, but, you know, obviously mine and yours, our workout schedules have kind of been a little bit wonky with, you know, this, but, and then all the sweets I eat, I would easily consume. I would take a guess. Throughout the day, I could consume anywhere between 8,000 to 10,000 calories. And that is a legitimate guess. You're probably like, really? Yes. All right, here comes. Here comes the syrup. Here we go. How many calories and carbs in Terramana? Good question. That would be zero. good question. So for the first time, just so you guys know, I wanted to be completely transparent in the world of the spirits business. And every time I drink and, you know, I like to tip the glass back a little bit, I always want to know, like, what's in my liquor, what's in my alcohol, and I have to go online and research. Well, I wanted to take that away from you guys. I wanted to show you right up front that we are gluten-free, no calories, no carbohydrates, in Terramana tequila, so enjoy. Okay, here we go. Here we go. What's up, Russia? Good to see you guys. Welcome. So say a prayer for me, brother, and I'll see you on down that line. Here we go. Here we go. Okay, you ready? This is the final thing going down right now. Look at this. Here we go. Get ready for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. You know, I just got to take another drink. You're like, damn, Rock, you did it to me again.
So, nose of the grindstone.
All right. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. All right. All right. Before I destroy this, let me just show you what this is like. Hold on. one second. There you go. You see that? I don't know if you could. There you go. So this is, for those of you who are just joining us, this is the brioche French toast cut 4 inches thick. It's a little compromised because I had to put it in a in the fridge because I made this actually last night and it covered it. When it covered it, it pressed it down. But anyway, I cut them 4 inches thick, sometimes a little bigger. And the brioche bread adds a little bit of a really sweet quality to it. And on top, what I like to do is, and oh, by the way, so what I normally do, just because a lot of you guys want to know the actual recipe, you're like, great, Rock, I could see you destroy that shit. Tell me the recipe. I need to know how to make it. So what I prefer to do is, and this goes a lot against a lot of chefs, I think, etiquette and their artistic vision about French toast. But for me, I don't like French toast that is weighed down heavy with creams and butters. So what I do is I remove all that and I use whole eggs, and I use milk, whole eggs, and a little bit of butter just for the pan. And that's it. And the sweetness in the brioche really brings out a quality. So it is 4 inches of brioche French toast. On top, what I like to do is smother it with peanut butter and then with jelly and then with syrup. Here we go. Cheers. Mm. That's good. Good question. How do I feel afterwards? Do I feel sluggish? Not really. I don't really feel sluggish after. I think because I'm fairly really disciplined and lean with my diet throughout the week. So by the time this hits my body and my bloodstream, you know, it usually gives me actually, instead of feeling sluggish, I actually feel a bit more energetic. Now, what happens in the middle of the night when I get sugar sweats because I consume way too much? This is a different story. So SportsCenter wants to know is what happens if you eat this and you don't work out? Well, SportsCenter, you get fat. This is good. I hope you guys can enjoy this. You know, this is all stuff that you're going to be able to get from your grocery store. I keep the ingredients really, really simple. From Bro Bible. Good to see you, Bro Bible. Those guys are my friends. Who's my favorite action stars growing up? My favorite action stars growing up were Harrison Ford, especially after I saw him in Star Wars and Empire Strikes Back, and then Indiana Jones, Raiders of the Lost Ark. Then I love Stallone. I love Schwarzenegger. Loved Clint Eastwood in some of his earlier movies. And let's see, Steve McQueen, fan of him, Charles Bronson. Just the dudes who are badass dudes who had, this is good. I don't know if you guys are out there eating, but hopefully you are enjoying your cheat meal. That's really cool. Somebody just said, I hope you sit back and take it all in. I do. I'm a grateful guy. Because, you know, people always ask, or not always ask, but I do get asked this often, like, how do I deal? How do I find balance? Is it hard being famous? Is it not? What is it like? You know, look, being famous is Fame is a funny thing. You got to be careful with it because it can explode in your face. But really all fame does is really magnify the human being that you already are. I honestly believe that. When you look back and you look at everybody who's famous and how they are, whether they're good eggs or they're not good eggs, good people or assholes, all fame does is really just magnify the person they already are, magnify their DNA and their makeup. So fame is a funny thing, and I try to keep it in check. I try to make sure that, you know, I live as simple core as possible, even though I can't go anywhere and I can't hide like most celebrities can, but I do always take it all in. I keep my family close, I keep my friends close, and the people who I work with, I make sure that they're not yes people. I've got tremendous partners and a team around me who, they don't yes me, they truth me. That's what I say, they truth me. They just tell me the truth. Once you tell me the truth, then I can make my own decision from there, and then I can be informed. Because you always want that. Look, whether you're famous or not, you want good people around you who are just gonna tell you the truth and not bullshit you. It's kind of shoot from the hip. I always think that's important. That's good. I did have a dream one time of being a country music singer. I was in Nashville, Tennessee. I lived in Nashville twice. When I was a little boy, and I also lived in Nashville when I was 15 years old, I was stuck in a little motel. My old man put me there. That's a long story. When I was 15, didn't have any money, but it was on Murfreesboro Road. Everybody in Nashville knows where that is. It was a little shithole motel. Anyway, this is one of the greatest songs ever written, Amos Lee, Arms of a Woman. Anyway, I digress. I used to spend a lot of time down on Music Row, and I did. I wanted to be a traditional country music singer. Had a decent voice I could carry a tune. But I wound up buying a car from a crackhead. I know, you're like, really? Where's this story going? It's a long story. They're all long stories. But it was the best thing that never happened to me. Even though I love traditional country music and I love music like this, that comes from a really resonant place in here when people write. But it's just like me making it in the NFL. Me making it to the NFL was the best thing that never happened. Thank you. I appreciate you guys. All right. I hope I'm not the only one eating. Because it's almost like we're all having brunch together or dinner or wherever you're at around the world. And I'm with right now almost 100,000 people. And I'm talking. And we're all talking to each other. I hope you're eating or drinking or doing something. Lord knows we have all the time in the world. One of my best friends just asked me a question. How do I stay calm in the pocket amidst all the craziness and when things get really hectic? Thank you, Brad Slater. There's a big bumblebee here. I like to think I'm one with the animals. Kevin Hart would fuck with me right now. If there's any kind of animal that comes around, a snake, a bumblebee, I mean, it could be a bug that is full of, you know, the rainbow colors that looks poisonous, and I'm always reaching out for it. Come here, I'm one with the animals. All right, Brad, how do I stay calm in the pocket? Thank you for asking that. That's our thing that we try to do. After I take one more bite, because I'm greedy. I I'm going to get sensey just for a second. So this song by Amos Lee, he's one of my favorite artists, and and this is one of my favorite songs, Being at Ease in the Arms of a Woman. It's one of those things where life could be so crazy and busy and hectic, and people pulling at you in a thousand different directions and responsibilities, and you wear multiple hats of a father, a husband, a businessman, a friend, everything that we are, that we all are around the world. But man, you know, sometimes it's like all you need is just that comforting place to fall. And in my life, that comforting place to fall, Kevin Hart is like, my lap? No, not your lap. Is in the arms of a woman. In the arms of my wife. Let me clarify, because when she watches it, she's like, a woman? No, you. All right. Anyway. Well, back to Brad's question really quickly. How do I set calm in the pocket? You know, I just try to remember that the road that I have traveled to get here has provided me with experience and skill sets. And even if it's something that I'm unfamiliar with, I have confidence in my gut and my instinct, and I have confidence in the people around me. So once I have all that, it allows me to be calm in the pocket, especially when situations get a little crazy. By the way, I mean, a prime example is now. We're all going through this thing. Thank you for that question. All right, so this is the evidence of a great cheat meal. It is all gone. That is the French toast, brioche French toast. It's the first time I'm wiping my mouth, by the way. Most important thing. Faith, yes, good question. I do have faith, I always have faith. But I always say it's not necessarily faith of a religious sense, even though I feel like I do have my own special relationship with the big man above and the universe. It's faith that things are gonna be okay. It's faith that things are gonna get better. That's what I believe in, and certainly we can apply it to this time now that we're dealing with this. All around the world, things will get better, and we gotta have faith. Good part coming up here. Here we go. I love this dude, he's good. This song is good. It's a classic. Alright, here we go. This is where everybody's like, oh shit, we're gonna get down. No, we're not gonna get down. Yeah, we are. Fuck it. You know what? It's that time. One more for the road. And for the road, meaning I ain't got no place to go. I don't have my guitar. I wish I did. I'd break that sumbitch out right now. This is blast. All right, everybody, get your drinks out. Raise your glasses. Because we got a big toast coming. It'll be nice. Mark Broussard, I appreciate you taking us home. There we go. It's a good question about tequila. I'm going to come back to that. Little thing. Thank you about the bartender comment. A few bartender buddies of mine taught me that. Kind of shake it up in different places. There we go. Appreciate you, Mark. And we're live and I can't get this thing off. Tony Baker Comedy, good to see you, brother. Hang in there, man. Your posts keep us all sane. Good to see you, Iraq. All right. I can't get this thing off. Here we go. I will not be defeated. You know what? It is. Here's the problem. Girl, that's how you make me feel sometimes. Hold on. Hold on one second. There we go. It's a good dude who keeps the country. His name is Whiskey Myers. There we go. Jesus. Here we go. All right, 1 second. Here we go. It's good luck right here. Here we go. I know these are all classic songs right here that I'm passing out. There we go. Ray LaMontagne, we did Saturday Night Live together. Incredible talent and voice. One more shake. Here we go. All right. Terramana Tequila, Sunrise. Raise your glass, because here we go. This toast is for everybody out there as you guys are continuing to go through this thing, as we're all continuing to manage and deal with this as best as we possibly can. Social distancing, shelter at home, quarantine. I mean, it's just what a wild and unpredictable moment that we're all in right now. But I do believe in my heart, deep truly in my bones, that we are definitely going to get through this, and we're going to get through it soon. We're going to start to see some flattening of the curves. I do believe that. And then eventually we're going to get back to a new normal, and we're going to get back to, I think we're all going to be better for this in some way. And I know that we're all affected by this thing. So I raise my glass to all of you guys around the world. This has been a blast. I appreciate it. And I appreciate you. We'll do this again next week. And maybe we'll have a little Terramana Tuesday this coming Tuesday, which I don't know what day it is. That might be tomorrow. Fuck, who knows? So cheers. And thanks for staying engaged and connected, by the way. This has always been fun. And I always say that I have one boss, and that is you guys. Well, most of you guys. Cheers. Well, you guys don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. You're like, I know, Rock. I got no fucking place to go but home. I know. Me too. But there's silver linings in everything. Silver linings in everything. All right. Bring this to a close. I love y'all. Cheers one more time. And you best believe that I'm going to be out here for the next few hours while my babies are taking a nap. Slap your hand. and I'm going to dust off this entire bottle. Cheers. I love y'all. Now, how the hell do I stop this? Oh, yes, up in the corner it says end. All right. There we go. All right, see you guys soon. Oh, did somebody say curtain call? I thought I heard somebody say curtain call. I thought I heard, like, everybody around the world say, curtain call, Rock. It's just a tequila talking at this point. I did come back because the one thing I wanted to say, which was very important, and I've been closing out all these posts with this, is stay healthy, my friends. Stay healthy and safe. I said I wasn't going to do this, but I'm going to do this. A very good friend of mine. I'm not going to tell you who it is, but he just lost his old man to coronavirus and to COVID-19. And I lost my old man too. So we both lost our old men, our dads, first quarter of this year. So brother, this one's for you. And this one's to our dads. Cheers. And cheers everybody out there around the world. Stay healthy. Love y'all. It never ends.